The long-awaited feature film version of the best-selling novel Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy hits theaters next month. The international thriller, set at the height of the Cold War years of the mid-20th century, a disgraced British spy played by actor Gary Oldman is rehired in secret by his government, which fears the British Secret Intelligence Service has been compromised by a double agent working for the soldiers. Whew, it's a mouthful. Gary Oldman joins us now, as does the film's director, Tomas Alfredson. They're both with us in studio this morning. Gentlemen, so good to see you this morning. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Tomas, let me ask you, first of all, you volunteered for this. You actually lobbied to direct this film, didn't you? Why did you want to be such a big part of this?
Well, it was when I saw this as a kid on television, I loved it, even though I really didn't understand everything. But there was something mysterious and magnetic about it. And then I, in my early 20s, I read a lot of the Le Carre books. So I was already a fan.
And when Gary was cast for this, what was your reaction?
Well, it was a long struggle to find the right George Smiley. It took us nearly 6 months. So it was a very relieving feeling.
All right. Well, Gary, yeah. Let me ask you about George Smiley. What's it like playing that character?
Well, it's a great opportunity. I mean, I've jokingly sort of said that this is, I've waited 30 years to play a part like this. I mean, it's an absolute dream. You know, it makes a change to be the smartest man in the room, because some of the characters I've played have not been very bright.
You have had an interesting run of characters. Talk about that a little bit, because you really, what people think about the characters that you've played and the roles that you've played, it's a villain, antagonist. I mean, these words seem to come to play. Do you enjoy that? Do you think it's a typecast role, or is this just something that you really get into, that type of character?
No, you can't. I mean, you can. There's an element of typecasting to it, because you are in somewhat at the mercy of the imagination of the people that are casting you. I've played my share of those big physical characters, so it was nice to play George, because he's, the emotions are all inside, so it's very contained and reined in. It's a sitting down part.
We love here in Washington a good spy story. Tell us a little bit about this, how this unfolds, and what folks would expect to see if they come see this.
Well, I think you explained it very well. George is, when we first meet George, he has been forced into retirement, and then they discover that there's a double working. He's one of five at the very top of the Secret Service, and so they recruit the master spy. They get me back in to investigate and find the mole.
Let me ask you, Tomas, about the process here when you put this together, and when you think about having to recreate this time period, what kind of challenges did you face there? Because you filmed this in several locations across Europe.
It's filmed in London and in Budapest for Budapest and Istanbul for Istanbul. But 80%, I would say, is shot in London. But we did this in a old military barracks in northern London, which gave us a lot, because most of it was from the actual time. So that was a very important part of it. But it's fun to recreate a very specified era.
Sure. You did a lot of research, obviously, into spies, into the history of spies. What was that like, and what did you find when you dug a little bit deeper into real-life situations?
Well, this thing with research can be so many things. I think a lot of people sort of hide behind research and say, oh, I read all these books about, the Cold War and the politics behind it and stuff. And research can also be, how do you look when you're lying to someone, like these people has to do? And those things really interested me.
Gary, how do you prepare for a role like this where you are aware of, as you said, it's an intelligent role, but it's also a role where your subtleties as an actor really make a huge difference in a film like this?
Well, to begin with, you have this fantastic source material. I mean, you were mentioning, you know, what, you know, when you dig a bit deeper, what do you find? You know, I mean, my homework or my research, if you will, was this fabulous book, and we also had access to the man himself, Jean Le Carré. You know, if we needed it, he was available to us. So I didn't really have to work very much outside the book, and of course, and I did. I met and spoke with John. So everything you need to know about the clues to playing Smiley are in that book.
But when we watch this film and we see some of the intensity, we can know that behind the scenes, you guys were having a good time doing this.
Yeah, we.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, we had some laughs. I mean, you get. I mean, John Hurt, who plays Control, is a great. I mean, not only a wonderful actor, but he's a great raconteur. I mean, he has fantastic stories, and I'm sitting across from Mr. Firth, Oscar winner Mr. Firth. We jokingly called him Sir Firth, and he's got a naughty twinkle in his eye. So it is dark. And austere, but we did. He's a funny guy.
I could tell. I could tell already. Listen, we're glad you guys enjoyed it, and we're certainly happy that you made it so that we can enjoy it as well, and all the good folks. I know you have a special screening. You guys are going to stick around tonight for that, but the film itself opens in December here in Washington. We wish you the best, and we thank you so much for stopping in this morning.
Yeah, thank you.
Gentlemen, it's been a pleasure. Allison, back to you.